Welcome to Castle Hill Avenue, the Castle Hill section of the Bronx. I'm gonna walk the whole strip. I'm gonna show you everything that's on this street. I'm gonna walk from the beginning to the end. But before I do it, I'm gonna show you the White Stone Bridge a little bit, because it's right here. So that's the White Stone Bridge over there, between the Bronx and Queens, East River. Okay. This is a secret park, Pusley Creek. I'm gonna start walking right now. These are new homes that they built around here like a couple of years ago. About to approach the YMCA. You can see Castle Hill Products up ahead, all those tall buildings, the brown ones. I'll be up there soon. It's the YMCA right there. See is right here. You know, the trees are covering it, but at least you saw a little bit of it. Here you go. Just letting y'all know I'm using a GoPro. It's attached to me. So I could have my hands could relax and stuff. So I'm not holding nothing. Using a chest mount, so it's like a body camera type. This is the 22 bus where it starts from. Zariga Avenue / Castle Avenue. That's Zariga Avenue right there, up there, Swole Street. What a cloudy day. So yeah, I'm gonna walk from Zariga Avenue to Tremont Avenue. Once I hit Tremont, that's where Castle Avenue ends, and that's where Bronxdale Avenue starts. And also that's the Parkchester / West Farms area of the Bronx. It's probably gonna take me like an hour to get here from here. It's probably like a 2-mile, 3-mile walk from here. It's great exercise, I could do it. Nice calm day. Not that busy out here. Come on, birds, get out of my way. This is probably the nicest part of Castle Hill, which is over here. It is the nicest part. After that, it gets regular once I get to the housing area and beyond, it's just regular. Then you got the businesses, so, you know, makes it more entertaining to see on this road. live recording on a GoPro because you get a full screen resolution. Way better than a cell phone, even for a digital camera. GoPro is the best recording device in history. Falls in the air, leaves changing color. Changing fast because, you know, seeds have been dry for the past month. Barely rained. Sunny sometimes, but it's done getting cool. And a windy, breezy day too as well. Yeah, that 22 bus ticket to Fordham on Valentine and Bedford Park by leaving college. So long ride, probably got an hour or so, depending on traffic. But at nighttime, take like 30 minutes. Yeah, dog, come after me. What's up? That's why I don't like going to people's gates close to it, because the dogs stay running. But the dog's doing this job, protecting the property. I don't blame him. This is Lacombe Avenue. As you can see, these are the Casio projects coming up. All of us know of people that lived in there, or we lived in there. Very popular part of the Bronx, very popular. Everybody knows of it. If you see, they're building new bus stops, shelter parks for people to stay under, protect yourself from bad weather. Supposed to rain today, so hopefully it doesn't rain on me while I'm walking this whole strip. Okay, we're really messing my whole video. And we'll have to stop it then. This is Randall Avenue. Community center to the left right there. Got all the stores to the right. I don't know if y'all can see it. My video's on widescreen, so I don't know if you can see to the side. I don't know. Y'all let me know. Also, these vehicles is blocking the view. Seward Avenue right here. Because the church is coming up, the left and the right. Just passed by St. John's Catholic Church and Fellowship Covian Church. This guy should have been here on this property for years. They always change the name though. So we're gonna see Crown Fried Chicken, Castle Hill Pizza, Chase Bank. I'm sure we know about this food spots. A slice of pizza here costs $4 right here. It went up. Lafayette Avenue. I don't know if y'all can see this, but you see the sign, Castle Avenue, right under the pole of the light. That's a new thing they've been doing lately. Make the street sign more noticeable, at least in the air. Yeah, right here. Close over Lafayette Avenue. Another church, St. Andrew's Church. That's Lafayette Park to the left. You go down the hill, you see some commons down there. This is the nursing home. This place been here for many decades, I know for sure. Change the colors, the building's still the same size. Mm-hmm. Story Avenue coming up, next block. The zip code is 10473. Coming up, going to approach the Castle Library and Top Banana Pizza. Okay, I'm going to show you right here. That's the library, and that's the pizza shop at Castle Hill. Also, one of the best Castle Hill pizzas, too. This is the Bronx Expressway. Interstate 278. And it's Brooklyn Boulevard as well. Once I cross this highway, the zip code is going to be 10472. And also, this is the Unionport section of the Bronx. I left Castle Hill section of the Bronx. This highway is merging Hutchinson Parkway, Cross Bronx Expressway. This is the Bruckner right here. Your Interstate 95, Interstate 295, Interstate 678, NSA 278. Also NSA 695. Here's a better view at the peace shot one more time. Highways merge over there, got the Bronx Expressway as well. That's Jimmy's calf right there. They moved from the Bruckner Plaza to over here. That's the location, new one right here. Yep, it's Jimmy's Cafe. Right there. Got the liquor spot, you know people love that. That's a liquor spot. You know, people love drinking, of course. That's the 24-hour one right here. Now you're gonna see all the businesses a lot more as I walk on the strip. I believe I walked half of the strip so far, another half to go. Got the laundromat, 24-hour laundromat right here. You got martial arts, karate. You don't see a few barbershops as well. It's gonna start getting busy around here too. More vehicles, more people, more stores, schools, churches, all the above. Houses, apartments. Coming up, it's across Bronx Pizza. This is Watson Avenue. Now you can see the sign right here. First time I see this big sign on the other side of the street right here. You see it right on the top. The left one, not the right, the left one. Now, that blue slash green sign, that's the Cross Bronx Pizza. Super slices, the long ones, people love it. See it way down there. These buses and trucks is covering the sign, but I'm sure y'all can see it from here. People think that's the blessed Castle Pizza of the area. keep going. It's across Bronx Expressway. It's a better angle of it. Across Bronx Pizza right there. Q44 bus right there. That's a select bus service. New bus design, the newest one's out. It's nice looking. That's the Cross Bronx right here, I-95. Looks the same like always. Surprised no traffic in it right now. It's shocking. Take this to George Washington Bridge, you go further south. Gas station right there, the gas. Another one. You're gonna see a couple of bars, lounges, and clubs as well. Forgot to mention that. Couple of banks as well, Banco Popular, Citibank. You got a couple of cell phone stores coming up, so restaurants, so you're gonna see everything. Also supermarket coming up soon. Another laundromat. Streets gotta be repaired, damaged. The firehouse is coming up. Coming up is Gleason Avenue. Firehouse right here. Chinese food, I love Chinese food everywhere. Soon as well. It's gonna start getting busy out here. Next block is a 6 train. Westchester Avenue. The 99 cent stores. Check cash in place. Go T-Mobile to the right and Boost Mobile's to the left. Texas place, H&R Block, Blimpies, Dunkin' Donuts, Baskin Robbins. Train. Got the Texas spot down there. Look, the burger's good. Yeah. So now we passed Westchester Avenue. So now I departed from Unionport. Now the left side is Parkchester and the right side is Westchester Square. I'll show you one last view of the train station. All right, this is it. All right. This is still Castle Avenue, just to let y'all know. Now the supermarket is closed, or maybe it's about to open. It's probably been around for many years. Right now it's like 12 p.m. right now. Of course, you know, you got corner stores like pretty much every block. Darling Avenue. So that's Parkchester down there. So you see it, all those buildings, Parkchester, that's where it begins. You'll see more of the Parkchester buildings as I come up more upward. St. Raymond's, I see. It's the school auto park, one of them. But the street called St. Raymond's is right here. They're remodeling it, renovating. Yeah, that's a school. Yeah, they redoing it. Yeah, one thing about Westchester Square, the streets move diagonally. It's narrow and all that, it's weird. Yeah. Pretty cool out here. Got a jacket on. Someone been over. See how the streets are? It's not really straight. It's like a 45 degree angle type street. That's how you know you're in Westchester Square, because the way the streets is made. See this? Yeah. As you can see, Parkchester, nothing has changed. The buildings still got the same color, same shape. Nothing new, looks the same. Mm-hmm. Metropolitan Avenue. Now you can see, really see more of Parkchester right here too. Now this is Zariga Avenue. I just came from Zariga from the beginning of my video. And now I'm at Zariga again. Amazing, right? That's the Riga Avenue right there. Now this last block, this is where Castle Avenue ends. East Tremont Avenue is right by that light coming up. The last church of Castle right here, that's St. Raymond's Church, or right here. Oh, that's that cavity. St. Raymond's too. So Parkchester's section is about to end. And also this video about to end. Cause right after here, when you go up the Bronx Avenue, it's the section between West Farms and Morris Park. West Farms to the left, Morris Park to the right. When you go up, when you pass over the ramp of the Metro North, the Amtrak, over the ramp. But Parkchester continues right here to the left. And more of Westchester Square to the right. So yes, you'll see more when I cross the street, what I'm talking about. You see this, how the street is diagonal? Move to the slanted, that's Bronxdale Avenue, that's where it begins. And you can see Parkchester's right there. When you go up Tremont right there, Parkchester. That's Westchester Square way down there. Started from here, Westchester Square. Oh, I can't even cross. Whoa.
Got distracted. Oops.
Fucked up. Oops. Busy talking to my patients to the road. Dangerous out here. Too much intersections around here. Try now. There you go. Whoopsie.
That's a one point right now.
Yeah, Westchester Square right here. Continuing from here, Westchester Square.
This is Tremont Avenue right here.
I
That's the Castle Avenue sign right there, to the left and right. I think East Tremont Avenue is the longest street in the Bronx. I'm not sure. Correct me if I'm wrong. Or it might be White Plains Road. Or Grand Concourse, or Webster Avenue. I know for sure one of those streets I just mentioned is a long street in the Bronx. I can tell you that much. So this is Bronxdale Avenue right here, Bronxdale. Like I said, once you go under the underpath, you're gonna be between Morris Park and West Farms. The central part of the Bronx, just about. All right, about to end this video right here. This is over. Castle done. All right, thanks for watching this video. If you like it, let me know, all right? Enjoy the rest of your day, or whatever. Let me get one last tour in the circle before I shut this off.